Wallahi, wabillahi, watallahi, Jannah was not created except for you, O servant of Allah. Except for you. It is a God-given gift to the person of La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. It is for us to assume the podium of excellence that Allah has given us by doing the do's and staying away from the don'ts and stop wasting time. Because enough is enough, O servants of Allah. Enough is enough. Allah says, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْ تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ وَلَا يَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَطَالَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَمَدْ فَقَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَكَثِيرٌ مِّنْهُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. Allah says, has a time not come, O servant of Allah? Has a time not come, O child of Adam? Has the time not come for your hearts to feel the khashya of Allah, to tear with the love for Allah, to have hope in Allah, to want to be obedient to Allah? Has the time not come for you to change yourself because of this Quran that Allah has revealed to you? And then Allah says, وَلَا يَكُونُ كَالَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ. Don't be like the people of the book before you. They had success, but they chose the dunya. They chose the temporary life instead of the akhirah. They became victims of time. They thought they wouldn't die. And because of that, they made this their jannah. So they became sinful. Many of them were sinful. Many of them were sinful. Their hearts became hardened and the sins began to pour. May Allah protect us from a hard heart. There's nothing worse than a hard heart. A hard rock is better than a hard heart. A hard rock is better than a hard heart. Allah tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah about rocks. وَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارِ. There's some rocks, they explode. Through them, springs explode from them. They give you water. They benefit you. وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَشَّقَّقُ فَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ الْمَاءِ. Some rocks, a crack happens in them and water comes out from it. Subhanallah, it benefits you. وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَهْبِطُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. And there's some rocks, you see them falling down the hills, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're rolling out of the fear of Allah. They have khashya, they fear Allah with respect. They understand who Allah is, the aura that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala owns. Hard rocks are better than hard hearts. But remember, we always have hope. And Allah gives us hope. Because after He tells us to change, He says, اِعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُحْيِي الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. He says, know and understand that it is Allah who gives life to dead land after it was dead. So Allah can give life to your dead heart after it is dead as well. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا. That, oh, you who believe, turn to Allah and seek repentance for your sins, a sincere repentance. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek forgiveness for your sins. This is the first step, O servants of Allah, that we rid ourselves of the sadness of shaitan that shaitan brings upon us. The job of shaitan, لِيُحْزِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. He wants to make the people of Iman sad. He wants to make us believe that we have no hope. He wants to make us believe that we're too old. We can't get Jannah anymore. We're going to die anytime. We're 35, we're 45, we may be 65 or 85. There's no hope left. Time is done. We cannot balance the scales. We've spent too many decades in sinning and spoiling the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We don't have hope. Rid yourself of those thoughts. Get rid of those thoughts. This is the first step, O servants of Allah. And to help you rid yourselves of these thoughts, understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for Himself amazing names, and names of mercy and compassion. And not just one name, but names. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Ghafir, and He is Al-Ghaffar, and He is Al-Ghafoor, and He is Al-Tawwab, and He is Al-Rahman, and He is Al-Rahim, and He is Al-Barr, and He is Al-Afu, and He is, and He is, and He is subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has chosen for Himself many, many names of compassion and mercy so that you and I, we never lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That no matter what we've done, as long as we are breathing, we know we have a door to turn to and get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have our slates clean. O servants of Allah, for the Muslim who does one sin, Allah says he is Al-Ghafir, the one who forgives your sins. For the Muslim who constantly falls into a sin after asking Allah to forgive him, some sins are too strong for us. We weak in front of it. We hate it. We're trying to get rid of it. But there's a process and there's a time span between us and leaving that sin. So we keep falling into that sin. Allah says, don't worry, for my name is Al-Ghaffar. Meaning, Allah is not the only one who forgives once, but is the one who perpetually forgives you, even if He just forgave you. And for the one who has sinned for decades and never turned to Allah and suddenly feels like he or she is going to die and they feel like I have no choice, what is 1 or 2 weeks of my life going to mean in front of decades of sin? Allah tells you, don't worry as well, for He has chosen for Himself another name known as Al-Ghafoor. Al-Ghafoor, which is upon the Arabic scale Al-Fa'ul. And any word on the scale denotes an occupation, which means Allah is telling us, my occupation is to forgive you. If you want to be forgiven, there's only one door that you can walk through, and that is through the door of Al-Ghafoor. So even if you have decades of sin, just walk through the door. It is my job to forgive you. It's your job to walk through. It's my job to forgive. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. And Allah, even with His mercy, He is Ar-Rahman, the entirely merciful. A mercy that encompasses the animals, the non-Muslims, and the Muslims. And then Allah says, I am Ar-Rahim, the especially merciful. Meaning, I have a special mercy for those who declare me as one and accept the prophecy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. For those who are Muslims, I have a special mercy for you. Wallahi, O servants of Allah, Allah gives the disbelievers when they make dua for Him, He gives them even though they insult Him, even though they disobey Him. So what about you, O servant of Allah? Rid the sadness of Iman by thinking these things, by understanding these realities. And then understand, O servant of Allah, that from the names of Allah is Al-Afu. Al-Afu refers to the eraser, refers to the effacer. Which means Allah is telling us that, you know what? When I forgive you in a way that the ground on which you did that sin is made to forget. And the angels who wrote that sin are made to forget. And the ink that has recorded your mistake is made to forget. And when you meet Allah on the day of Qiyamah, it's as if you never did it in the first place. This is the perfection of the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, Al-Wahid Al-Qahhar, Al-Ahad Al-Samad, Al-Ladhi Lam Yalid Wa Lam Yulad, Wa Lam Yakul Lahu Kufuwan Ahad. O servants of Allah, it is Allah who said Himself in a hadith Qudsi, Yabna Adam, O son of Adam, إنكم تخطئون بالليل والنهار وأنا أغفر الذنوب جميعا فاستغفروني أغفر لكم. That you sin in the day and you sin in the night. You make these mistakes. But it's only Allah who forgives you in the day, and it is only Allah who forgives you at night. Turn to Allah and Allah will forgive you. It is Allah who says, Ya ibn Adam, O son of Adam, لو بلغت ذنوبك أنان السماء ثم استغفرت لي لغفرتها لك ولا أبالي. O son of Adam, if you sinned and sinned and sinned, that your sins fill the surfaces of the environments that you lived in, that your sins reached the levels of the clouds, that your sins reached the skies. That is how sinful you were. ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَ لِي. And then you sincerely regretted what you did. You sincerely hate your past. And you sincerely intend Allah and His Jannah. And you turn to Allah. And you seek forgiveness from your heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ. Allah doesn't say, seek forgiveness from me and I will forgive you. No. Ar-Rahman says, seek forgiveness from me and consider yourself forgiven. La ilaha illallah. Don't get up and doubt that if I die, maybe Allah has forgiven me. Maybe He hasn't forgiven me. No. Allah says, aghfir lakum. I am telling you, seek sincerely and consider it done. This is the good hope Allah wants you to have in Him when He has these names, O servants of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, let none of you die except that you die having good hope in Allah, that He's forgiven you, that He's accepted your deeds. This is how a Muslim dies, right? A Muslim is one who teaches other people to live in his dying, and he teaches other people how to die in his living. When he lives, he's attached to Allah. When he makes a mistake, he turns to Allah. And when he dies having good hope in Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, subhanahu wa ta'ala.